Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the live stream of our 4 o'clock Vigil Mass here from St. Joseph Parish in Mechanicsburg as we prepare to celebrate the Most Holy Trinity. We're so glad that you're here worshiping with us this evening and wanted to take this opportunity to provide you with a few reminders as we prepare to celebrate our liturgy. If you need a copy of our worship aid, you can access that by going to our website, www.stjosephmech.org, and it'll be right there for you on the homepage with our music and readings and all the responses for the Mass. If you've come to the church and are in your vehicle and don't wish to use some of your data, you can actually tune in on your radio to 95.5 FM. Again, that's 95.5 FM, and our Mass will be broadcast over that radio station. If you are in your vehicle and are listening to the Mass, when Mass has concluded and the faithful inside the church have received Holy Communion, Father will then come outside to the front portico to distribute Holy Communion to any of you who may be waiting outside. Finally, we remind you that, as always, you are able to put any special intentions that you have in the comments section of this video, and Father will take those with him to the altar this evening. Once again, we welcome you here and look forward to worshiping together as the one body of Christ.
Such a joy to be with you here in our church, and especially on this feast. Last week was Pentecost, this week an even, I want to say better feast, I'll just say as great a feast of the Holy Trinity, in which we celebrate a God who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and that He lives within us. But brothers and sisters, before we can come to a full realization of the true gifts we have received, first we must acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to enter into these sacred mysteries. You were said to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Now, mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery. Grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This indeed is a stiff-necked people, yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways. Encourage one another. Agree with one another. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
So that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord. It is so good to be back with you in this church. It is such a joy to be here. And although it's not the same, we're still here with the same Lord who will feed us with his life today. So great to be with you. Now, I just want you to take a second. I want you to look around the church. How many images of the Trinity are in this church? Those standing up will be escorted out immediately. Anyone have a guess? Anyone have a guess? No one? No one wants to look foolish. Well, I'll suggest. Is there more than three? Okay, where are they? Okay, there. I see the Holy Spirit, right? And Jesus. Maybe not God the Father. Well, I'll tell you the answer in a second. Because it's a little misleading, the question. In the first reading, God is revealed to the people of the Old Testament. Now we know that the Trinity has existed in eternity. There was never a time when the Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, did not exist. But in the Old Testament, the people only knew of God the Father. It would have been heresy for a Jewish person to think that God was two or three. They only knew that God was one, and that was the Father. So in the first reading, you know, Moses goes up to the mountain to get the law. And he asks for God to be in there. But they don't know the fullness of God. They were not given that gift. They were not allowed to live in the time where they knew the God of the Trinity. And then we come to the gospel. And the times when Jesus lived. Now, the people at his baptism knew of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit because the Holy Spirit was present. And Jesus talked about the Spirit. But the Holy Spirit really was not made present in the way we know him today. Of course, again, he was always there. But even in Jesus' time, the understanding of God as Father, Son was difficult enough for the people. They thought he was blasphemous then. But then, in the second reading we hear, St. Paul said, grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father, communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. It was after Pentecost when people finally understood that God was three, not one. Of course, we knew about it in the Gospels, and Jesus talked about it, but it was really made manifest at Pentecost. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God the Father, the Creator. God the Son, who came forth from the Father and showed us the image of the Father. But brothers and sisters, even knowing God the Father and the Son, and even knowing that the Holy Spirit exists, it's still a relationship, in our minds at least, of something that is there, somewhere, up there in heaven, not available to us. But the truth is, because of Pentecost, when the power of God was given to those apostles, and then through time has been given to each one of us in the sacraments, especially for our baptism, brothers and sisters, we are the life of the Trinity. The Trinity is in each one of us, not just in images. So how many images of the Trinity are there in this church? Right now, about 100. Now there's just one part artistic image, and it's in the back. I think it's just one. And if you'll notice it on the way in the church, that sign, it's a beautiful image of God the Father with the three, with the triangle. But in this church tonight, and through all those who desire to be with us, especially at this altar, in this Mass, in the communion of saints, the Trinity is present in a manifold way. But brothers and sisters, if we can't even see the Trinity present in each one of us in this church, when we're in church, believe me, it's hard to see the Trinity that lives in those outside of here. Maybe those that giant. Put on a mask. I don't want to wear a mask. Or you can't come in without a mask. Get angry. Or maybe someone steals the last slice of pizza from the refrigerator. And you get angry. And I'm just talking about the seminarian. Seminarian Dan is very good to us, and he cooks very well, so I would never get angry if he stole the last slice of pizza, just that one. But it's so hard to see the presence of the Holy Spirit and Father and Son of the Trinity in each one of us. But because of our baptism and because of the sacraments, he lives in us. God, the Trinity, lives in us. But that's put to the test. And I think this week, these last 2 weeks, I think especially, as there's been upheaval in our country, because we witnessed a horrific act. An act that cannot be assuaged or put aside. An act of injustice. And when George Floyd was killed. And so there is anger. George Floyd had the indwelling of the Holy Spirit, of the Trinity in him. Those protesters who were angry had the indwelling of the Holy Spirit in them. The people who were victimized by some of the protesters had the indwelling of the Holy Spirit in them. All those of us who, because of the media or our society, are forced to pick one side or the other, which is wrong, have the Holy Spirit and the Trinity dwelling in us. There is no silence. We belong to a family of the Trinity. The family of the Trinity does not segregate based on race. The family of the Trinity does not segregate based on what country you live in or what political party you believe in. The family of the Trinity is one. And we are told in our second reading that, hey, we all want peace. Peace at any cost. Well, peace doesn't come by human works alone. It first comes from God. And then it comes from our actions. The peace of God on this earth comes through the actions of us who have the Trinity dwelling in us. Do people see the Trinity in us? Would they recognize him in us? But in the second reading, it says that there will only be peace if we give peace through our love of each other, through our getting along with each other. Tough. Very tough. But it will not happen by some accident. It only happens because the Trinity, which dwells in us, will act through us. And of course, through God's grace, which he desires at any time. But the second reading tells us, if we love, then the God of peace and love will be with us. But when we do not, would anyone recognize the Trinity in us? Brothers and sisters, we come today here on this great feast, not only to celebrate a Trinity that exists somewhere else, but to celebrate and to thank God and praise him for a Trinity which we are so blessed in this time to have dwell in us here. Will the Trinity meet this church here and in the form of us and spread peace and the desire that the Trinity desires? Brothers and sisters, if we do not take the Trinity who is given to us in the sacraments today with us, will anyone out there know the Trinity exists? And now let us stand and proudly profess this faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and justified. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Let us pray to the Lord, who is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, faithfulness, and peace.
Our response is, Lord, receive our prayer. For the church, may all who share one baptism find unity in the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
For all peoples of earth, may we learn to live with each other in harmony and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
That we may all be aware of the life of the Trinity that dwells in each one of us, may we would desire to bring this presence of love and unity to everyone we meet, regardless of race or any other earthly division which may seek to separate us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
For peace in lands torn by war, natural disaster, and economic hardship. For peace in every heart riddled with unrest. That God will keep all military, police, and first responders safe in their service to us, and that all immigrants, refugees, and persecuted Christians throughout the world will know the Lord's presence in their struggles. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
For all the intentions in our hearts and those offered on our live stream broadcast, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
For our beloved departed, especially Caroline Ball, Bree Dien, Kay Snyder, Connie Weiser, and for Andrew Schock, whom we remember at this Mass today, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayers, Heavenly Father, by the power of the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that, in confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. And your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
we will be receiving Holy Communion at the end of this Mass, we now pray the prayer for spiritual communion for those at home. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, it's wonderful to be here with you today. Just a few reminders in case you were not here for Mass last weekend. Communion will now take place as soon as Father and I come to the altar. We will say, Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, he will kneel. And then after that is over, your ushers will lead you forward. Please make sure that you see the sanitizer there. Please make sure that you sanitize your hands before you approach for Holy Communion. And then, if you're wearing your mask, before you are about to receive, to pull your mask down so that you can then receive. It is difficult to receive with your mask up. I try. But you need to pull the mask down. Receive, and then please just exit straight out these doors. I hope that is acceptable for all of you. Once we are finished with everyone here in this congregation, we'll then go out to the outside. For those who were watching in their cars or who did not feel comfortable coming inside for Mass, we will then, Father and I will then distribute Holy Communion to those people, and we are glad to do that after every Mass, and that is an option that is present as well. Thank you very much for your cooperation with all the procedures. We know that this is happening everywhere, and we're sorry that it has to happen here, but this is necessary so that we can be together in this way and receive the power of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit through the sacraments. What a great gift we have received. And now let's pray the prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, you are an angel. Defend us in the hour. You are our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God have you in your humble prayer. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits, the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
once again, if you were able to watch this live stream or listen to it from your vehicle, as soon as the faithful have finished receiving communion here in the church, Father will come out to the front portico so that you may also receive Holy Communion. We thank you once again for worshiping with us this evening, and we look forward to worshiping together again soon as a parish family. May God bless you.